the kids out into clubs and stuff where they can actually be more social and interacting with more people like them that are into it is going to veer them off in the correct direction as opposed to going off in the bad direction. So I think we're making a positive change. There was James Welton and Bill Liao were the founders, and basically what had happened was James Welton, who's still only 20 years of age, two and a half years ago, he designed this website for students in Ireland and he won a competition. And when he went up to collect his award, he won a raffle on the day and he won a little iPad Nano, but it was pink. So what's an 18-year-old fella going to do with an iPad Nano that's pink? So he said, I'm going to play with this and hacking away at it. He was one of the first people to be able to do what he wanted to do with on this generation of iDevice. He released the exploit on the internet overnight and woke up the following morning to a bit of a media sensation. And he started a club in his school after that, and he thought that 5 people might turn up, and 40 turned up. So a couple of months later, he was had to talk at a conference after his exploit, and he met a gentleman called Bill Liao, who's a Chinese Australian guy, and I just realised that the Irish ICT in Irish schools is very poor, and there was nothing. It wasn't going to change overnight. We have a great shortage of programmers needed in Ireland. They estimate about 5,000 at the moment. So they said, let's go roots. Let's start training them early and getting them in. So they came up with the idea for the clubs, and I class it as a perfect storm. It was just the right idea, right timing, right backing, right people behind it, and it's just taken off from there. Coder Dojo. So coder for computer programmer. And the idea behind Dojo is that in martial arts, a dojo is where people go to learn martial arts. So that's one part for the club. The other part is that the philosophy behind the dojo is that as they come up through and they learn, they go back down and start teaching the kids themselves. So we get the kids as much as possible doing the mentoring in the dojos. We're the adults who are from industry are only there to mentor them and point them in the right direction. You get the kids doing as much as possible. One of the golden rules is ask two, then ask me. So ask two of the kids around you and then come and ask me before I give you the answer. 23 countries, 200 dojos around the world at the moment, and growing weekly. So we're making sure that it's not a classroom. We try to keep out of the school system. It shouldn't be something where kids have to do it in school. Once you sort of say, oh, you have to do this, that turns them away from it straight away. So we're keeping it as after school clubs, and then we're trying to keep it fun for the kids. We're trying to make it so that they're teaching each other. So the club mentality, we don't do lectures, we do mentoring. That's it. Well, sort of your average groups, because we've only done a survey in the last couple of days and I'm seeing the data coming back in, your average group is sort of 30 to 40. I run one in Ireland where we have about 110 to 140 kids every week. It's a club. Okay. We have over 100 kids every Saturday. Every Saturday they turn up, and because they come in to meet their friends, they come in to work on problems that they've hit over the week at stuff they're doing at home, and they have fun with it. You're always going to have failures. I've said it to Ellie here, like, don't get worried when kids come in. You get it every week, new kids coming in through the door. It's not for them, but at least they now know it's not for them. It's better that they know now before they go into first year in computer science and they fail out after going the wrong route. So they get to find out. Yeah, we have some great success stories. We have a couple of 13, 14 year olds in Ireland who have developed their own apps. One of them, his game was top of the iStore for a day, like for a pizza app. We have another young lad in Dublin who is developing a library software for small school libraries to be able to run a complete library on an iPad. So yeah, we have, and he's actually set up a proper business, the whole lot out of this, still only 14 years of age. Scouts for the 21st century.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, that's the way I see it. It's scouts for the 21st century.